So, I mean, can you say what kind of player did you get today? Describe for us what you think you're getting back in this goaltender.
Well, I think we're getting a goaltender not only of the present but of the future. I think that certainly Marty is at a point where, you know, he can't play the way he played as far as the number of games he's played. And this young man has proven to be a number one goaltender, and we feel great about it. I've spoken to him, and he's just excited to come here and work with Marty.
Now, you have a number one already. Does this signal that you're going to guard, obviously, for 41-year-old Marty Winter?
Well, Marty is still number one goaltender. There's no question there. And it's just a question of how much he can play to keep him at the top of his game. You know, the back-to-back games, and certainly with the Olympic team, the Olympic year coming, where there's going to be a condensed schedule, it'll be, you know, very, I don't want to say difficult, but this gives us that transition that we feel we would have loved to have gotten maybe a year ago if it was possible. This is something that we feel just outstanding about.
Do you have a chance to talk to Marty?
I haven't spoken to Marty or Hetty. I haven't left the floor. Like every other trade, you just, you know, a lot of phone calls, a lot of conversations, but I won't get into how it came about.
After hearing so much about Luongo the last year, were you surprised that Schneider came on the market?
I'm never surprised at anything in this game. When, you know, it comes to transactions, all we were, you know, focused in on, and once we thought that there was a chance of doing it, then we pursued it.
Lou, what happened to that with Hedberg?
I'm going to sit down with Hetty and talk to him, and, you know, just see where we're at there.
So you're a guy who likes to draft young players. What was your thoughts about giving up the ninth pick or something you had to do?
Well, I think that if there was a goaltender at the ninth pick that we felt could definitely play in the NHL, we probably would have taken him. So now we have a goaltender who's, you know, already experienced, a goaltender who's proven he can be a number one goaltender at the age of 26, 27. I don't think you have a choice.
Lou, is a buyout an option with Hedberg?
Pardon me?
Is a buyout?
I have no thoughts right now on anything at this point.
Lou, how much of a relief is it to just know you've got your goalie of the future now after all those last few years of wondering what's going to happen when Marty finally retires?
Well, I really was never wondering what was going to happen because he just kept getting younger and younger. And every time we thought, but this was an opportunity and timing was perfect. You don't do anything just for the sake of doing it, and we were just fortunate to be in the right place, have a position in the draft that made this work, and we were able to take advantage of it.
Lou, does this affect things with Marty beyond this year, or are you just...
No, this doesn't affect Marty. We'll see, you know, see how Marty is, how long he wants to play, and, you know, we've always had conversations of him, you know, making a transition at some time. We have to do it. I'm sure all of us have to do it at some time.
Lou, Marty said earlier, he was talking about some of the financial issues that have arisen surrounding the Devils, perhaps affecting future transactions. Has that been anything that's a concern of yours?
Well, I'm not going to get into anything that has to do with our organization, but I think that if we notice what we did today, I think it's an indication that, you know, we're pushing forward and we'll be, you know, signing or announcing some of our free agent signings in the very near future.
Did you make this trade last night? It was completed last night, I mean, and did you hold on to it to announce it during the draft?
I don't know what that means.
Did you agree to it last night and then you just hold on to announce it before until when was it completed?
I don't really talk about when we complete them or don't complete them. It doesn't matter. It's when it's announced that it's a completed trade.
Snyder, he seemed to be pretty happy about coming to New Jersey. Did you get that in your conversation with him when you spoke to him?
Yes, I did. I mean, he's from Boston. That's his home. Played at Boston College. Actually played on the same college team with two of our players. Brian Johnson and Peter Harrell played for a year with him. So he knows a lot about our organization through them. And in fact, he told me even before I spoke to him, I guess Peter Harrell had texted him or something. You know, we've watched him right through college. We watched him grow. And, you know, he's one of the top goaltenders in the league.
You made some trades today. How do you think you did in your draft?
Well, we're happy. Our scouts are happy. You know, we've got a size and strength defenseman, and we got a center iceman that has a lot of potential. In fact, plays with Doug Gilmore, who was here yesterday, who had, you know, big reviews on him. And so we'll see. We'll see when we get him in the development camp.
Lou, how far back did you go when you started targeting Corey Schneider as the guy? Like, how, when did that become a reality for you?
Well, I don't think that, well, it became a reality once the trade was consummated, but I think you look at all players in the league, where they're at, what the set of circumstances are, what potentially can help, what can't help. So it's not a case of that you're all pinpointing this. It's just you have to be aware of everything that's going on and then see if there's something that can help and there's a fit for you for the team. And, you know, and that's the way it ends. You always make a transaction that both teams come out of it feel good. Vancouver, they came out with an outstanding young player. So, you know, they had two number one goaltenders, so they made a decision. You know, we all make them for different reasons.
How do you concentrate now, Lou, on getting some offense now that you've secured the back end?
Well, we have to look into the free agency, there's no question. You know, get our players signed, and, you know, simultaneously, but we'll do whatever we can to make us better.
Lou, Marty's motivation has never been a question, but it must be a healthy thing, bringing in a young goalie like Schneider's accomplished so much and being able to push him as he gets older.
Well, if you know Marty, Marty doesn't need anyone to push him. Marty doesn't compete against anyone. He competes against himself. You know, he's an elite athlete, tremendous pride, team player. I don't worry about Marty, you know, looking over his shoulder or anything like that. Marty's too much of a professional, and, you know, he'll help Corey as much as anybody will.
You said you're confident you'll get your UFAs taken care of before the agency is.
I'm saying that we're working on them, and we'll be announcing, you know, a few of them very shortly.